What are you doing to create these comics? Like, what are you using? Now you've got the outlines are done in color. You're coloring them in, putting in backgrounds. So, like, what tools are you using and how do you go about creating the comic?
Okay, so I got my computer. It's a laptop. So yeah, I have my laptop. I have my drawing tablet.
Okay.
And the program I use is Medibang Paint.
So do I.
And
I love
yeah,
that program.
Yeah, I like it. Like, I saw someone use it like on one day like in a speed paint, and I was like, huh, I wonder how that's like. And then I found out it was free, and I was like, this is great.
Exactly.
So. So I've been using it basically ever since The Wonderful World of Whatever. Mm-hmm. And the way how I go about making comics is, so for the Gag a Day ones, the one that's like things are just kind of happening, I wrote down like notes. So like on my computer, I wrote down basically the gist of each episode, the gist of each comic of like what happens, like, this person is like mad about something, or like someone is, I'm thinking of things off the top of my head,
no,
not even
fine.
Like examples, but like, let's say I write down like, oh, someone is talking about how hungry they are. And like, I just write down like one sentence ideas of
yeah.
like what's going on. In fact, for The Wonderful World of Whatever, I used to like write them down in a book. But then over time, I didn't like most of the ideas. They were kind of pretty cringy. So I like just scrapped that and like just wrote new ideas on my computer. And that carried over to the Four Friendly Humors. For doing Fine Supine, I wanted to practice writing a story, not just events that happen on the daily.
Right.
So I decided, okay, I made a note, like in the notes app on my Mac, and, it's really just like, it's just titled The Four Friendly Humors, Doing Fine Supine. And it's just a checklist of the whole plot. So like, basically each bullet point is supposed to be like, an episode or like a couple of episodes. And like, as I draw each one, I just check it off. And
yeah.
Then I like, well, when I'm done drawing it, I check it off. And like, and then this allows me to know sort of what happens in the beginning, what happens in the end, and what's going on generally in the middle, while allowing me to get surprised and like see what's happening. Because I've heard that some webcomic artists do decide to like just come up with like the beginning, the ending, and then just kind of like a general idea of what happens.
Like fill it in while you're going along.
Yeah, so that they can be surprised. Other people write scripts, and I'm like, that
right.
seems interesting, but I wanted to try out, like, just kind of, like, winging it. And I thought that was very interesting, because at one point I read this, like, guide that one artist on Tapas made about, like, basically just, like, tips and advice for how to make webcomics,
mm-hmm.
how to make your story, like, better, how to make the art better. But I saw something about the story. Things, you know, start out okay, but not as great. And then, like, towards the end, as, like, things begin to go wrong, things make things, like, basically as bad as possible in the end. Not, like, totally bad, but just, like, you know, like, you know,
oh,
how
like
in
conflict.
A hero's journey, you know how in a hero's journey, like, things happen to the main character,
yeah.
and like, you know, each trial becomes a little difficult, but they learn from stuff. And then at the end, they have to like surpass a big task.
Mm-hmm.
And like, sometimes you see in movies that before that happens, things start to go very badly for them, and they have to use what they learned to like overcome that. And that kind of just makes their jump much greater and makes the story more interesting. And so I read that and I looked back at my notes and I was like, you know, the ending of Doing Fine Supine could be better. It was kind of lackluster. Like, I don't want to spoil so much.
Yeah.
But like, basically it seemed like, meh, like it didn't really like show like something bad going happen. Things won't go like terribly bad. I'm just saying, because it's like, it wouldn't fit the theme of my story. But basically I decided to rewrite the ending and make things like a little bit worse, like
mm-hmm.
for our characters, but
right.
basically something that will test whether or not they can be friends,
Yeah.
really.
And I get what
And
you're saying. Like,
so,
one of the things, the reason that that kind of advice is good is because, especially when drawing a comic, it's so one thing I've noticed is when you get to the last panel, it feels so much like you want to resolve it, like, or put in the punchline, or like the last one has to be like, bottom bum, or whatever. And
yeah.
it's, and leaving it hanging or kind of stretching it over into the next one is seems like good advice, especially for something like yours that is being more serialized.